Have you wondered whether God wants you to be with someone? Have you been longing to be with someone, but you don't know if God approves of that person? Are you desirous to know what would happen when you meet someone that God wants you to be with? How would I know the person I'm with is the person God wants for me? You might have been asking yourself what God will do when you're with someone He has planned for you. In this article, we would examine what God does when you're with someone He wants. We don't always know what is best for us, and that is why we must always watch out for what God is saying in every step we take or action we embark on. The choice of who we spend our time and life with is a paramount decision, that if mistakes are made, we would live the remaining days of our lives in regret, pain, sorrow, and heartbreak without being able to fulfill a purpose. We need to be deliberate when making this choice, and we have to know what God is saying about it and what He's doing about it. Just like parents sometimes talk to their children using gesture, sign, and action, God also communicates things to us using gesture, signs, and action. There are times we're so distracted or too busy that we're not hearing what God is saying, but as a loving Father, He would still look for means to communicate with us because He wants the best for us in all things. In Jeremiah 29:11, "For I know the plans and thoughts that I have for you, says the Lord, plans for peace and well-being and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope." What God wants for us is to be great and have a great and fulfilling future here on earth. And since He is our maker and owner, we ought to look up to Him always, know what He's saying about us, and walk in that light. God is delighted in the relationship we keep. When He created man, He was interested to have a relationship with him. Relationship between opposite gender is mostly aimed towards marriage, and God was the one who instituted marriage. He values companionship, and He joined the first marriage union on earth between Adam and Eve. And this shows He is delighted in our happiness and wants us to get it right. Remember that He took bind from the body structure of Adam to make Eve. It was a perfect match, and this points the facts to us that we must get it right. We must locate the person that our bone was taken to create. We must find the person whose bone was used to create me. Finding that person is the first step towards a long-lasting relationship. It would be a hard task to start assembling people in the hospital to be operated so that their bones will be checked whether it is a match with ours. Remember that Adam was fast asleep when God removed part of his bone to create Eve. He woke up to see her and declared, "This is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh," which implies that there was this connection that he saw in her with him, because he never knew what God did. Genesis 2:20-24. "And the man gave names to all the livestock, and to the birds of the air, and to every animal of the field. But for Adam there was not found a helper that was suitable, a companion for him. 21. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and while he slept, he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh at that place. 22. And the rib which the Lord God had taken from the man, he made, fashioned, formed into a woman. And he brought her, and presented her to the man. 23. Then Adam said, "This is now bone of my bones, and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man." 24. "For this reason, a man shall leave his father and his mother, and shall be joined to his wife. And they shall become one flesh." We are a spiritual being, and as such, we must discern what God would do to prove to us or make us know whether the person we're with is approved by God. What are those things God would do when He wants you with someone? 1. He gives both of you peace. 2. You find companionship in the person, helper, answer, and support. 3. Alignment and connection. 4. Growth. He gives you peace. God desires that we prosper and be in health. It is His delight that we have peace of mind and in all things. No one gives peace than the peace that God gives. One of the things God does is that when you're with the person He prepared for you, He would work things to give you both peace. Peace is a state of rest in mind and all things. One of the things to watch out for is whether you're having peace with that person. Isaac in the Bible, after losing his father and mother, wasn't having peace in his life until the coming of his wife Rebecca. There was no peace in his life till when she came. Her emergence in his life brought peace. When there is peace, joy thrives. This is also seen in the life of Ruth. Nothing was right in her life. No peace, no joy. She was laboring. But the time she met Boaz and he married her, her story changed. Her life was lightened up with peace and joy. And it also spread to her mother-in-law, Naomi. The Bible also made us know that he who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from the Lord. You don't have favor in crisis. It is the emergency of the right person to your life that gives you peace and attracts favor from God and man. Look out and watch carefully. Has God given you peace with that person? You find companionship in the person, helper, answer, and support. You fight better when you're assisted by someone. This is another thing God does when you're with the right person He wants for you. He makes you find true companionship, help, answer, and support. When you're with the right person, God goes to work to ensure you find rest in that person. Aside from having peace, you find rest. It is possible to have peace but no rest, but when you're with the person God wants for you, He would grant rest through companionship. Rebecca comforted Isaac, and he was able to walk better. She supported him, was an answer to his life longing, and helped him in doing what God has mandated him. Adam found such companionship in Eve. She was the answer to his loneliness, and she supported him and helped him in doing what God wanted. Abraham also experienced this with Sarah, his wife. Israel didn't find that companionship in Leah, and that was why he still sacrificed to have Rachel, because it was God's gift to him, and she was the one he loved more. It was God doing these things. When you don't find companionship in that person, you need to check it out, because one of the things God does when you're with someone He wants for you is that He gives you companionship. You see a helper, answer to your longings, and strong support. Alignment and connection. Another thing God does when you're with someone He wants for you is that He brings you both to balance and the same in spirit and purpose. Imagine God has called you to travel to a far nation as a missionary, to teach the people there about Him. He will not give you someone who wants to stay in your current place and work as a banker. There would be alignment. The person would also have the conviction to travel with someone to go teach the gospel. There can't be a fulfillment of life's assignment and purpose when there is no alignment and connection. The person God wants for you would be ready to move with you to the next phase. Sarah was ready to move to where God was asking Abraham to go. The wives of Israel, Jacob, were the ones that told him it was time for them to move to the next place and leave their father's house. The person God would give you would be aligned and connected to your dream. There would be a similarity of the assignment. He would not give you someone that would take your attention from the assignment He has given you. Instead, He would give you someone that would run it with you. When you're with someone God wants for you, He would work to ensure that you both are aligned and connected. If it is lacking, it might not be the person God wants for you. Growth. One great thing God does when you're with someone He's prepared for you is that growth sets in between the both of you. We are to continually grow to the stature, and it is only achievable when we're with the right person prepared by God. You can only grow with someone you're at peace with. Find a companion in, aligned and connected to. Growth would set in. You both would grow and develop together. But when you're with the wrong person, growth is stunted. It looks as if you're decreasing instead of gaining stature. God is pleased when we get things right. He's always doing things for our good. He's interested in everything that concerns us, relationship inclusive, and He would do things to your good when you're with the person He wants you would see them and know. You would not miss out of these things.